can get everybody for you. That prettiest girl here, he's like.
Oh yeah.
I haven't seen almost all of these. That's something.
I'll just send this to your email.
That's great stuff.
Isn't it?
I've never seen it before.
Is
it,
is that Kim?
This is just a flip.
That's Kim and that's Nora.
Oh, okay.
So that's, yeah. I'm not sure who that is. Do you know who that is? The little blonde boy? If that's my mom, I'm a, maybe it's a friend. Maybe it's a friend's son. Somebody, you know, yeah.
I thought it might be my brother. He had blonde hair, and he was.
And we can't make out who, unfortunately, is behind him. That would probably be the clue. For the clue.
He grew that in his garden.
Yeah.
Oh, I had a picture of him holding a snake that big.
Man, zucchini. How much that thing weigh?
I think I was like 3, I don't remember.
You could work out, yeah.
He always dressed up for Halloween when I was little. Yeah. I remember him taking a fishing cork and burning.
I don't think there's any of Aunt Frances here. Yeah, these are him later, pretty much.
Yeah, I got the bigger vehicle. Oh, yeah.
That's what I'm saying. I can maneuver stuff around, but I don't know how to do it with wrong, you know. Yeah.
I can take two pretty
slightly. That looks like my dad on the tractor, doesn't it? I'm still recording.
What was Danny's middle name?
His first name was Joseph.
Oh, that's beautiful.
All right.
Thank you. I can't tell when anybody's taking it. You can't hear anything, see anything.
I know. The old one. Hey.
Oh, thank you. Here it is.
Yeah.
Put a marker right here for
us. That's what we're waiting for.
Yeah, you've already got it ordered?
Yeah. Okay, good. That's good.
It's crazy. I don't know why. I'll walk on the other side. They're going to put it right there with that. They gave us that thing with the name on it.
And that's appropriate. Great granddaughter.
Look at my skirt.
There did they have to. Why did your mother? They didn't. Your mother's
mom and dad is.
They are on the corner.
And granddaughter?
Oh,
where do you want to put it right here?
It's in pretty good there. And he had a bunch of wires.
I'm so afraid I'm going to poke some.
Yeah, but he said it was really wrapped around there.
Oh, the wire was?
The wire, yeah, once it hung on the thing. He kept throwing it. And that
my son died February.
Just around the.
What, 18th, Bob?
Pardon me?
Danny.
What?
He was February 18th, wasn't he? Or?
Would it come off the basket?
Put it on the front of his bucket.
He made a fine man.
Got fine.
Three little grandbabies. Oh. And he thinks, and you know, we all of them call Danny grandpa. And of course, whenever he started to be a grandpa.
I'm trying to get.
Yeah, the worst comes to worst. I mean, if the wind blows.
It's not gonna.
It's gonna take a half a
because Michael walks, talks, moves, and looks so much like Danny, is freaking us out. So I'm trying to get him. I have to show my mom.
She's seen me fairly recently.
Yeah.
Yeah, I did see her after 2005.
That's it. Another dog. When I would visit him and say, I've not done my dishes, and this is a great attitude, he would say, in 100 years, no one will even know. And I like that. What's important, what's not important.
I heard y'all talking
earlier about him not wearing his hearing aids, and Nora told me that too. He said the last few years he refused to wear his hearing aids. That's it. You know, writer of Ecclesiastes says there's nothing new under the sun. So after so many years, you've probably heard it all. So, and there's not for you to say. That's crazy. That's a great story. A neighbor. Check on him, buy his groceries for him, and give him his medication. So he'll be a good it's what friends and loving friends and neighbors do also. Sue would say we helped him and he helped us. And that is so true. A lot of times we receive more than we ever give. So it's a wonderful thing about friendships. Fortunately,
same. Okay. Sorry.
And we did get that. And he would probably never acknowledge that. But yes,
he gave
right.
More
yeah,
than
we received
to
more
than
more.
She gave in taking care of him.
Oh, that's nice.
Got more.
He died the day before he was to go to the nursing home. The doctor called me to tell me he was in good spirits. And he said, no. And the doctor said he had asked for some coffee, which he did. Got up here in the morning, checked the mail, made coffee. Yeah. He told them he wanted to pray. The next thing they heard him say was, Lord, take me.
That's where I always start crying.
What'd you say?
That makes her cry. Oh, I'm sorry.
It's okay. That's okay. He would tell you his day schedule. You would go out, get his newspaper, come back in, and make some coffee. Then he would make his frozen dinner. laugh and share great stories. And that's, there is a wonderful story about, and I never did it right. I don't know. It was about Leo Tolstoy, a Russian writer. But one of his colleagues at Tolstoy's death told the people who were there, he said, "Look, what a wonderful person has lived on this earth." And I think we can do that so many times with our friends and neighbors when we step back and we think, "Gosh, what a wonderful person has lived on this earth and has been part of my life." There are going to be times when you will do or say something that reminds you of him. Sometimes it may be a phrase that he used, or you're going to step back and you're going to say, "Wow, that sounds just like Dad, or it sounds like Uncle Henry, or it sounds like Granddad." Or you'll experience something that reminds you of a time when you were growing up, and you'll smile, and you may tear up a little bit, but you'll smile because you're remembering him. And that special memory belongs only to you. There's not another one like it in history. So celebrate those moments. Celebrate those moments. Continue to remember that each of you has a part of Henry Conway woven into the fabric of who you are. In fact, many of you may be able to say that you would be less than the person you are if he had not been in your life. So when you think of him, think of how he influenced you in good, positive ways, and remember him so very fondly. Tear up and cry if you want to, but smile also because you have known such a special individual. Being here together today, like we are, you can look at each other and look around and look at the photos here and remind each other about him and those special moments. And do that. Enjoy. I know it's like a family reunion. I know we were talking about that just briefly standing in the aisle right there. It is like a family reunion, and those are wonderful things. But talk about him and realize that you talk about him and maybe even share this thing. "God, look what a wonderful person has lived on this earth, and I am fortunate to have had him in my life." Remember. Let's bow for a word of prayer, please, also. Almighty.